One St. Ignatius Community Garden is cultivating soil and soul.
Everything stems from the foundation of our soil.
A small garden is helping feed the surrounding community.
I feel like it's healing for the community.
Fred Billings teaches a class called Garden for Life, where students spend an hour learning about connections to land and then applying the lessons in the garden.
So basically what we're doing out here is teaching a very efficient way of growing organic produce.
Billings says there are parallels between people and soil.
It eats, it breathes, it drinks, and it works. It's alive, and it's alive with billions of microorganisms.
Not only is there a garden in St. Ignatius, but there are six more around the reservation. From Arlie to Pablo to Elmo, the gardens support a circular food system in the Mission Valley.
This garden and all the other gardens that we're working on is some of our efforts to help fulfill the Tribal Council's Food Sovereignty Initiative. They passed several months ago, asking all tribal entities to do what they can to help improve the food security on the reservation.
In other words, the Tribal Council wanted to create a food system where the people were in control of the production and distribution. The food from these community gardens is donated to the Food Distribution Center, elderly homes, and the Boys and Girls Club.
The people that are in this class right now are feeding hundreds of people that would not otherwise be able to get fresh produce.
Anyone can take a class, visit, or help out. Those who spend time in the gardens don't mind getting their hands dirty.
I never even wear gloves when I'm out here. I feel like when my hands are actually in the dirt, and I love when I can have my feet in the dirt. It's that you're grounded and you're more connected.
I love that part of it. Fred taught us how to moisture test in the dirt by how the soil filled in our hands, and I went home and taught my grandchildren.
In St. Ignatius, Emily Brown, MTN News.